Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
It is so good to see you guys. We're excited to hang out with you this evening, but if you can just excuse me for 1 minute. Finny, we agreed that we were going to dress festive. What's going on? There's hardly anything going on in your scene.
Okay, first of all, I have a thing with Santa hats, so I didn't go that direction, but let's talk about this. Boom. I got sweatpants on, not festive, but festive casual. I got Christmas socks on. Okay, and wait. There's a lot happening off camera. We've got a little Christmas tree or Charlie Brown Christmas tree, Advent wreath, 4 candles lit because that's where we're at, and, of course, my little nativity baby Jesus ready to go.
Okay, I must say, I didn't give you enough credit, and I must say I've never
underestimated me as usual, so.
Well, you know. Yeah, and I've never seen a pewter baby Jesus that looks like it belongs in a Monopoly game before.
But. Oh, it is from Nativity Monopoly. I always try and get the angel Gabriel. I always get baby Jesus, though.
Okay. Well, there you go. Wherever fine games are sold, I suppose. There you go.
Yeah.
That's great.
But one more thing. I also might be on my third glass of eggnog, so okay. Merry Christmas.
I don't know if it's actually eggnog in there, is it, Finny?
Whoa. Anyways, we are so glad you're here. We are wanting to just share with you a few ways that we like to celebrate Christmas for your enjoyment, knowing that even though we can't be together in person, we can be together virtually and celebrate that way.
So whatever you've got in your glass tonight, we hope that you can sit back and enjoy a very virtual Christmas from us to you.
Hello, my friends. So good to see you. I know this time of year we would have gotten together to sing some carols and have some potluck. And though there's nothing I can do about bringing you potluck, I can bring you carols. So I hope that you enjoy this time of singing. And my hope is that you are singing too, and that we get to celebrate soon together. Merry, merry, merry Christmas. Hopefully you know this. Go tell it on the mountain. Shepherds kept their watching.
Hello from the Claussen family. One of our Christmas traditions is the Christmas can. This little can always has a new surprise in it every year. One year there was even a pair of pants rolled up inside of this little can. Every year there's something different. Sometimes it's something small, sometimes something big, sometimes it's really funny, sometimes it's just boring. But always there's something in the Christmas can. Wishing you all a very Merry Christmas.
Hey everyone. Okay, so this tradition, it's not like long-standing, but Ben is Dutch. And for those of you that are Dutch, you might know this, but one of the traditions at Christmas for the Dutch tradition is to give everyone in the family a chocolate letter. So that is a tradition. Now, my tradition is to convince my kids that they don't want to eat their chocolate letter, and therefore I get to snack on it. So I'm sort of modeling this for you a little bit ahead of time with my own here, but you know, for the sake of the video. So one of my traditions is to sneak chocolate whenever I can. Now, as my kids get older, this does get a little bit harder, but so far my tactic is to convince them that chocolate fondue is the best thing ever, and then melt these guys into a delicious fondue. Merry Christmas.
My mom is pretty talented, and she made us the biggest and the best stockings ever.
You look at mommy's phone, okay? Just wait. Merry Christmas, everyone. Just wanted to say hi from Mat Leave. We've been having fun as a family this year, getting up to see the lights and making a gingerbread house and trying to get creative on new Christmas traditions. Maddie, do you want to say Merry Christmas?
Merry Christmas.
Can you tell them what we celebrate at Christmas time?
Well, what we celebrate at Christmas time?
What do we celebrate?
Jesus' birthday.
That's right, Jesus' birthday. We hope you all have a great holiday season.
Well, we hope that you've been enjoying this program so far. It is really lovely for us to share with you some of our favorite traditions. Hopefully you're singing along with the carols that Anna led us in. And trivia, are you keeping your own score? Finny, don't worry about it. I took it upon myself to keep score for the both of us. And according to my scoring, it's 1,000 to 0.
Zero? I got at least 2.
Hey,
it's rigged.
I don't make the rules. I don't make the rules.
Okay, whatever. Well, anyways, onward and upwards, we are going to be decorating some cookies with our very own Diane Claussen. Before we get to that, Carmen, do you have the latest Zoom update on your computer?
Yeah, it's updated. Why?
Okay, we got to try this new feature. You ready?
Yeah.
Speaking of cookies, you got to try this guy right here. You ready? I'm going to try and, yeah, should be, there it is. Give that a bite.
That is incredible.
Right?
Not an ounce of freshness was lost in that transfer. Unreal.
Christmas magic.
Wow. Let's get on to the real cookie decorating, shall we?
Hi, everyone. I'm so glad to hang out with you for a little while. We are going to decorate some Christmas cookies together. Here are our cookies. We have some little trees and some stars and some circles that we can make into Christmas ornaments. So we are going to make the icing together. So the first thing that we need to put in our recipe is icing sugar. So we need 1.5 cups. So we'll do 3 halves. So 1, 2, and 3. All right. And then the next thing we need is 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. So we'll just add that in. 1/2 teaspoon. And then the next thing we need is some corn syrup. And the corn syrup is going to give the icing just a little bit of a shine. So we'll add in our corn syrup. Just use this. There we go. And then the next thing we need is just a little dash of salt. And then we need a little water. So we're gonna add 2 tablespoons of water. 1 and 2. And then we're going to whisk it up. And when you're whisking it up, if you find that your icing is a little bit too thick, you can add a little more water. Or if you find it's a little too runny, you can add just a little bit more icing sugar. So you would just mix it up. Oops, I'm spilling it all over. Just mix it up until it's all the powder is mixed in, the icing sugar. And then I just used a little spatula and bring it down like this off of your whisk. And I think it looks a little too thick, so I'm just gonna add a little bit more water. That. And then, oh, we'll just stir that up just a little bit more with our spatula. And then I just took this that I made and I divided it into four smaller bowls. And then I added some color to each of those. So we had red and yellow and green. And now this one we're going to make into blue. So we'll just take our blue food dye and just add just a little bit in there. And then we'll take our spoon and we'll just stir that up. Stir it, stir it, stir it, stir it. And then it's ready to go. And one thing that I discovered when I was teaching kindergarten and preschool was using paint brushes to decorate the cookies. It's a really fun way to do it. So let's use the yellow and we'll do a star. So you can just take your paintbrush and then you just paint it on like this. And all over your star. And then you can either add some sprinkles. So I have some shiny sprinkles. You can use any kind. You might want to take, here we'll use some of our blue. We'll just put a little bit of detail on there. You can do it however you like. And another idea that I have done is putting two different colors of icing and then using a toothpick. And you can just draw the toothpick through the icing. And then you'll get something that looks a little bit like this. So those are just some different ways that you can decorate your cookies. Let's just finish this one. And then after you're finished making them all, you can eat them all, but another nice thing to do might be to package some up and do a porch drop off to your neighbors or to your family members. Another thing that you might wanna do is make a Zoom call together with your home church or some of your friends, and you could do it all together. And that would be a really fun thing to do, and then you can give those away or you can eat them online together. There's lots of different ways that we can use these to give away to our neighbors and our friends at Christmas. Anyways, thanks for joining me. Merry Christmas. Bye.
So we're sharing our Christmas traditions that we have traditions of every year. And so this is our Christmas tradition. And like always, there's actually our house is very well decorated. And people always say to me like, Kate, you've done such a great job. And I'm like, it's not me, it's my dad. He loves decorating. He does all the decorating. He decorated this tree. Now there's one thing I just wanted to point out to you. One of these decorations is not like the other. And this is our Christmas tradition. This is like a little bit of like a parental advisement warning, but this is my dad's favorite decoration, and it's from when he was 5 years old, from like 1955. Sorry to date you, Dad. But it's this. This. There's all these like cute little ornaments, and then there's this. Look at this arm. Like, it's terrifying, like baby, like no arm. Anyway, yeah. And like, I always try to put it at the back of the tree. I always try to like sneak it way back here, but no. Super prominent. My brother and I call it the ugly baby ornament. It's so scary. It's like a Halloween Christmas ornament. Anyway, that's happening.
Hi, church family. Merry Christmas. One tradition that was significant growing up in my house was a Christmas village. So my dad started to collect a few different buildings and people, and then over the years it grew and grew until it took over at least half of our living room. It involved setting up several tables and all kinds of lights and snow. But each of us had a little figurine that was us in the village. Our house was there, a church, a farm, all kinds of buildings. And we loved, once it was set up every year, kind of playing with it and rearranging all the little people and looking at all the different scenes. And we have pictures of our kids enjoying it too when they were little. And then now in the last few years, as it became a lot to set up for my parents, they have kind of dispersed the village amongst my brothers and sister and I. And so we have a little mini village in our house now, which I also really enjoy. I love that it reminds me of my dad. I love that it reminds me of playing with it together with my family.
Kathy and Harley and Kobe. Just wanted to share my favorite Christmas tradition from growing up. We didn't have a Christmas tree, so instead, every Christmas Eve, my parents would wrap up our gifts and hide them all over the house. The best part of that tradition was we would find gifts all throughout the year that they had forgotten about. Christmas all year long. It was perfect. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Hello, Merry Christmas, everybody, from the Bergman family.
Kimora should be on this side of the tree. Oh, goodness. She's taller.
Gracious Jesus.
All right.
Somebody needs to stop with that.
What? Gracious Jesus?
No, the gas. No. Someone's doing it.
So good. What?
One of our Christmas traditions is a special Christmas breakfast with...
Forgot to say that we have a Jamaican background.
Oh my gosh, Mom.
Do we need to do that?
Yes, we do. We're Jamaican.
Hey, that's our background.
Hi, my name is Xavier from the Bergman family.
Yes, you are.
And this is what we do for Christmas.
We celebrate Christmas is by having a...
Watch where your head is, Quincy. Stay in your frame.
Hello, we're the Bergman family, and one of our big Christmas traditions is a special Christmas breakfast with ackee and saltfish, fried dumpling, fried plantain, bacon and sausage with a nice cup of eggnog or cocoa tea, and it's one of the best parts of our Christmas tradition. Oh, and music every time.
Hey. Here's a look at one of my favorite Christmas traditions. It is a small nativity set that I've had for years. It belonged to my grandparents, and then it got passed along to my parents and me, and I have always enjoyed setting it up, and the little baby Jesus who is in his little wooden manger. It's special because I remember setting it up every Christmas as a kid, and I still have it now in my place, and there's also like some sheep and shepherds, and the wise men are off to the other side. But another really tasty tradition that my family has always done is we make these special cookies only ever at Christmas. My mom is, her background is Latvian, and there's a cookie that literally is translated into pepper cookie, and we make that every year, but only at Christmas. Roll it really, really thin and cut it out with Christmas cookie cutters, and they are so delicious. Thanks for hearing about my tradition. Love you, church family.
What? There's a lot going on here. What the heck are you doing?
Okay. Please show some respect. I'm doing my dance segment. I was told there'd be a dance segment, and I was told that my version was denied. So I have no idea why, so I just wanted people to get a glimpse of what they're missing. Because apparently we're going in another direction.
And I am very glad we have chosen to go in another direction, because you're not wrong. We are heading into a dance segment, but thank goodness for all of us, it's going to be led by our very own Kate Brown, who actually happens to kind of know what she's doing with this stuff. So
wow.
Right. Let's head there together. Enjoy this, everyone.
Okay, here we go. Hello, my name is Kate. I'm the community pastor, and I'm here with my friend Leah.
Hi.
Leah Davis. I'm sure you remember her from last year with her amazing narration. Leah is my friend and neighbor, and we are here in this very snowy night to welcome you into the physical activity portion of the evening. So this is your chance to get on your feet. You're going to learn some dance moves with Leah and I. Ready to go, Leah? Feeling good? Okay, so before we start, we are just going to teach you some moves, and we're going to be dancing to the classic Christmas carol by Mariah Carey, All I Want for Christmas Is You, and All of the Snow. Okay, so here we go. First move. At the beginning of the song, you need definitely someone who's got some star-like qualities, so that's why we do have Leah here with us. But so figure out who in your family has the star-like quality, and if you're sort of like none of us, then you just have to vote for someone. And if it's all of you, well then, this is your moment. So, the beginning is through, the snow is crazy. You're going to be hitting a pose. So, to the beat of the song, let's do an example. You're gonna hit a pose. And then you're gonna hit a pose. And then you're gonna hit a pose. And you're gonna hit a pose. Until you hear the line, all I want for Christmas is you. Okay, were you with me so far? Great. Okay, next up, we are gonna do just some very, these are very simple moves. You can follow along. So, we just got some hip hops, a little bit of hip hop action. You guys got this. And for the guys out there that are feeling like not feeling great about hip hops, you can just do a little shoulder action if you want. That also works for like hip hops, yep. And then we're gonna take it into a step touch, right here. And if you've ever seen the movie Hitch, you know that this is home. Anyone can do this. This is a classic dance move. Again, you can get some shoulders going if you want. And then from there, we're gonna take it up a notch. And what are we gonna do next, Leah?
Clap.
We're gonna clap. We're gonna take it to the clap right here, like this. Yeah. Oh, right, Milo. All right, he's in. He's in. Okay, and then what? What else we got? We got some snaps. What do you think about the snaps? Okay, so the snaps are gonna start low. You do 8 snaps all the way up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and down. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We'll do that a couple times. But I think you get it. I think you get it. And now, yeah. Great. Okay, then next up, we have just your classic shimmy. Any way you want, freestyle. Shimmy is a family. Okay, that's great. Great shimmying, great shimmying. Okay, and then next, we have a classic grapevine. So, this is maybe the most challenging move of the evening, but you have got this, and we are doing it at half tempo, and Leah's already demonstrating it for you. So we are gonna go step with your outside foot, whatever way you're going, behind, step, touch, step, behind, step, you got it. Step, behind, step, touch, step, behind, step, touch. And finally, we're gonna finish off with the classic roll move, which is just step and roll and step and roll, step and roll, step and roll. Okay, are you feeling ready? The main thing here is just to really have fun. And for those of you that are thinking like, I'm a little bit exhausted, this Christmas is a little bit tiring, I promise you, this is a great way to shake off that stress and any sadness you might be feeling. So ready to go, Leah?
Okay, yep.
Ready for our pose, here we go. Leah? Ready, family? You probably own those poses.
So one of the Christmas traditions in the Eager home is that we always go and cut down a real Christmas tree for Christmas. And we do it every year. We take the kids, they let you walk through the forest and find the one you like, and then you cut it down and you bring it home. It's lots of fun. We make a whole day out of it. By the end, the kids are usually, you know, tired and cold and snot-faced and crying, and then we try and take family pictures, but it's really great, which is why, you know, we only do it once a year, but it's great. You bring the tree home, you put it up in the house, it just, you know, makes the house smell like pine, so it's great until, you know, it starts to dry out a little bit, and then these needles start to fall, and then they get in the carpet and stab you in the foot, but it's really great having a real Christmas tree. There's just something authentic about it. That's our tradition. I recommend it What's yours?
Hey friends, Merry Christmas from the Busick household. I'm so glad to be here. Anyways, I just wanted to share, actually not a tradition, but a secret. I dislike baking. Now, what does that mean at Christmas when baking seems to be one of the things to do? Well, you gotta start a cookie exchange. So let me just show you. On my dining room table, our home church got together to do a cookie exchange, and that is 7 households times 7 dozen. So that's 49 dozen baked goods that are being exchanged between these households, and I can't wait to share, but also to eat them. Anyways, Merry Christmas to you, and I hope to see you all soon.
Well, let's keep singing. I feel like Christmas wouldn't be Christmas unless we sang this hymn. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him a room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And
night.
and we hope that you have enjoyed this program. It's been a joy for us to be together in this way. And as we wrap up, we want to share with you a reading that we've prepared.
It was the night before Christmas at the old warehouse site. I found parking easily, which didn't seem right. The lights were all out and the crushed space was bare. It felt like a year since a soul had been there.
I drove home bewildered and asked, is it true? Could the lockdown have taken all of them from me too? A house with no meeting was all that remained. Where'd my church go? Could someone explain?
Pastors were working from mostly their beds, while visions of Zoom calls danced in their heads. The meetings were set. The links were all sent. Home church would now be an online event.
They told me we're here and that they still care. We could talk about anything if I wanted to share. I considered unmuting, but what would I say? I missed being with friends in the usual way.
I sought the new website, all fancy and slick. It promised community with only one click. I scrolled and I surfed and found lots to do, but where could one register for a hug or two?
Joined a live stream and said hi in the chat. I never knew churches could gather like that. I texted my question. On air, it was read. Join the after party for answers, they said.
I took to the socials to look for insight. Surely a meme could make everything right. My people, I see them. Everyone's here. I knew that my church had to be near.
Pictures of everyone trying to cope. The smiles and comforts gave me some hope. I'd comment and like and even follow. But hearts on a screen still left me hollow.
But just when I thought I could no more endure, I pondered the many blessings that were, teaching and prayer, gathering and song, the things I thought lost I had had all along.
When what to my wandering eyes should appear, a vision of love casting out fear. All this time longing, and I never knew that the people I sought had been seeking me too.
Perhaps the church was never a place, rather a people. Defined by grace, joined together in one accord, a holy temple in the Lord.
What of Christmas? Could we save the big day? As community red zones quickly turned gray? More masks, more Sani, and arrows on the floor. Bring face shields, sign waivers. We've got to do more.
Now pastors, now elders, now small group leaders, on mentors, on ushers, coaches, and prayers. Line up, line up. There's a new protocol. Vaccinate, vaccinate, vaccinate all.
But with December here, it's not soon enough to have the gathering we're all dreaming of. Wishing that Christmas be all it should be seems too much to ask of 2020.
Stuck all alone, I knew not what to do. With everything else, was hope canceled too? I got down on my knees right then and there and called out to God and offered this prayer.
Jesus, we're sorry we couldn't come through and give you the rightful honor you're due. What type of party is this going to be? Will you still come and will you be pleased?
Then in my heart, I felt drawn to the light with magi and shepherds like on that first night. With hope and some fear and without gift to bring, I came just as I was to worship the King.
But I found the place humble, as if by design. This was his Christmas, O night divine. And if the whole world could change on that night, the meeting house too might be all right.
So thank you, dear God, through the gift of your Son, that your distanced people are united as one. And I heard him exclaim, as my ears did incline, Merry Christmas, my children, beloved church of mine. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas. The Lord has come. Letter received her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing.
Computer's
falling.
Hold on. I have it propped on a blanket.
Come on.
Some of our favorite traditions. Hopefully you had a chance to sing along with Anna leading us in some carols. And are you keeping track of, hold on, I think I'm talking with the cookie in my hand. I'm pretty sure I'm doing a lot of this. So let's pause one more time.
Okay, from the top.
Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Hold on, there is a lot of background noise for me.
Oh, okay. Are you keeping track of trivia? Freddie, for the record, I've taken it upon myself to keep score for the both of us. And according to my scoring methods, it's 1,000 to 0 so far.
What? I got at least 2. This is rigged. I'm going to be... You let me know I can log a formal complaint. Let's try it again. Log. That was too long a pause. Log. Log.
Yeah.
Log. I'm going to try one of these cookies. You ready? Is it coming? You got it?
I do.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Sorry. Can we go again? I think it came up like here.
It wasn't good.
I know. I wasn't. I hadn't practiced.
Okay.
Great.
Do you want to count me in?
Yeah.
I'll get into my...
You've got this. Do you not want to be standing?
Now I'm good sitting. Good with the shoulder. Keeping it in frame.
Yeah, that's okay. All right, ready? Okay.
I feel like I let us down, guys. My computer dinged twice.
Oh, did it? I didn't even hear it.
If you didn't
hear
it,
there was one really loud ding. There was one, I only heard one. It was really good other than that. It was real. It's almost worth just forgetting it, keeping it.
So I'm just prepared. Do better overall.
More. Is given.
So just try not to, everybody just try not to suck.
Act hard. It'll be great. Everybody act hard. Act hard.
Maybe Finny, just tone it down a bit.
Yeah,
Finny, I'm doing like 20% more than I think I should.
Yeah. Finny, you're just right.
Maybe dial it back 5%.
Just stay there.
Yeah.
You're 5% less, Finny.
You come up to my level.
Okay, am I good to hit stop recording? We're good?
I believe so.
Thanks, Carolyn.